infant's financial health is not good. Individual factors such as education and training, experience, personality, age, social factors, the financial system, the economy, and just plain luck are all at work, states a book written by the Federal Reserve Bank of San Francisco. Today, I'd like to inform you about the importance of personal finance for the future generations, why it should be a mandatory class in high school, and how it can affect the future of our country. Teaching kids about financial matters in school can help keep them from getting into trouble with debt after graduation. Our kids are going to take one of two paths in life, future education or employment, and both require basic financial skills. So today I'm going to talk about the need to educate our youth about finance, where we are with teaching personal finance in schools, and why we need to teach personal finance in high school. Let's start by talking about why we need to educate our youth about finance. The need to educate our youth about finance is greater than ever before. There are many obtainable temptations nowadays, and as kids get older and they get on the internet, just like with TV, they're overwhelmed with propaganda to get the latest and greatest toys or electronics. And then as they get a little bit older, buying items online becomes even easier. There's no real thought or effort, it's just click and buy. And not only are there more temptations to purchase the latest and greatest, but obtaining a credit card is now easier than ever before. Credit card companies even have agreements between banks and schools, so it's making it even easier for our students to acquire debt. So where are we with personal finance and education in high schools? There's been a lot of research done about teaching personal finance. And according to the Council for Economics and Education, 20 states require high school students to take a course in general economics, but only 5 states require a standalone semester in personal finance. And while I was researching why so little schools teach personal finance, I kept coming back to a couple of the same issues. One is that there's no standardized test, so how do we know if it's being taught? The reason there's no standardized test is because school is mandated by the state and not by the federal government, so it's hard to come across the standardized testing. I interviewed Sherry Stevie, a PhD candidate in personal finance. She's also a private financial counselor for working and military families, an author of some personal financial articles, and an instructor of an undergrad personal finance planning course at K-State University. She states that one of the reasons and issues with teaching personal finance in high school is that the teachers themselves don't know that much about handling their own finances. Teachers were never taught how to teach personal finance skills, and they may struggle with their own money management. If a state wants to mandate financial education in K-12 schools, they're going to need to provide the support to teachers to learn the skills for their own use and partner with experts in the community to facilitate. Another problem is that the behavior of parents and the community around these students has much more of an impact on students than any lesson taught in a school. Many parents are not in a position to teach current financial skills to their children. Just like many parents don't possess the knowledge to teach their children calculus. They may not be participating in general retirement account investings. They may not have checking accounts. They may have poor credit scores. Their financial product and service market is changing faster and faster every day. And it's difficult for even the experts to keep up. So how is a working family going to stay abreast of everything going on out there? They're probably not. So let's talk about why we need to teach personal finance in high schools. Like we said, after graduation, high school students are going to take one of two paths. They're either going to continue education or they're going to go out and get a job, get employment. Either way, basic financial skills are needed to avoid lifelong mistakes. If they choose higher education, tuition is more expensive every year. And then those who go on to employment, they may go to some for-profit job training. For-profit job training organizations target low financial literacy populations. And a large percent of them never finish their program, and if they do, they're low-wage jobs anyways. Those reasons cause students to have many debt and difficulty with, have heavy debt and difficulty paying them off. And that in turn affects the ability to borrow money at a low interest rate, qualify for rental housing, or obtain a job that requires a good credit score. The National Jump Coalition for Personal Finance Literacy conducted a survey that found a large number of high school students had no basic financial knowledge of financial concepts. They didn't even know what types of various bank accounts they were, let alone stocks, bonds, educational funds, and IRAs. But in 2010, Georgia, Idaho, and Texas, they mandated personal finance in high school. And according to the National Finance Educators Council, 3 years after the mandate, all three states showed an increase in credit scores and a lower delinquency rate on their credit accounts. So we know that it can work. And this affects our country because the lack of knowledge in preparing for retirement has caused many Americans to live below the poverty line. We're under this false impression that Social Security is enough to live on during retirement years. And this false mindset that Social Security, because this is a false mindset, Social Security was never meant to be the main source of retirement income. In addition, Social Security Administration hasn't even been able to give a cost of living increase in several years. So let's teach our kids to fund 529 plans or educational savings account. Let's teach them not to overindulge in student loans. Let them know they don't have to take that large student loan just because it's offered. Take what they need for school and start paying it off as soon as you get it. So this afternoon, we talked about why we should teach personal finance in the school. We considered why the need to educate is now greater than ever. We looked at the difficulties of teaching personal finance in high school. And finally, we considered why we should teach personal finance in high school. So talk to your child's school, talk to your school board, talk to a state representative. Let's get our economy under control and educate our children about personal finance so they no longer have to carry that financial and psychological stress and burden of debt. Remember, parents and communities have more impact on students than any lesson taught in school. So let's educate ourselves as parents and caregivers and allow for better financial conversations at home. These reasons conclude that adding personal finance to education to high school curriculum will benefit our students now, for their future, and for the future of the United States of America. So when youth are faced with purchases, especially those large purchases such as homes and cars, college tuition, they make smart financial decisions that don't start their adult years in debt. Thank you.